Can see the hair is getting wild. I think I'm gonna grow it out a little bit this time and not cut it off. We'll see. Oh boy. You know, people, sometimes you got to be socked in the nose before you finally wake the fuck up. Sometimes you actually have to be bitch slapped, you know? Because words and demonstrations and information, data just doesn't mean anything to people. So look at the world right now. What is the number one problem? Flooding. Brazil, wow. I mean, you have entire towns, cities underwater. Eighty-five people dead, 150,000 displaced. This is just El Dorado do Sul. Horses up on the roofs of barns that are only like 2 feet from being underwater. Flood and see, for the last, I'd say, 2 years, these floods in the United States, Europe, South America, China, pretty much everywhere have been called storms, 100-year storms, 1,000-year storms. Have you noticed that? You see, the oil industry still likes to use that term. Oh, it's a 100-year storm. So, the wet bulb issue, I don't know if you know what that is. Look it up on Google. Yeah, this is the problem. You see, when you warm the planet, you warm the atmosphere. When you warm the atmosphere, you allow it to carry more moisture. That causes more rain. It's simple. It's simple. It's not complicated. There's no mystery. There's no once in a thousand year storm happening. When you warm the atmosphere, it holds more water, so the rain events are more severe, and we just don't have the infrastructure for it. Our fucking drainage system and things were built to handle rain that was, not that we never had floods, okay, but our drainage systems were not designed or meant to handle this kind of water. You got to remember that, especially in the United States, right? The East and shit, that stuff was put under fucking ground 80 years ago, 100 years ago. It's just not meant to handle this. Once again, it's very simple. The reason that the entire world is having 100-year floods, I bet if you went to Vegas and tried to get odds, that they wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole, that it was a 100-year flood, and that next year is going to be just as bad or worse. The year after that is going to be just as bad or worse. And the year after that is going to be just as bad or worse. We're not going back. Okay? Warmer atmosphere allows it to carry more water, which means more rain. I don't believe the average person understands how, when you look at a major thunderstorm, I don't think people understand that there is literally billions of gallons of water hanging in the air. Billions of gallons of water hanging up there in the air. I don't think people understand that or realize that. And when you warm the atmosphere, it holds more. So when it rains more. It's childlike logic. Childlike. You don't need to be a climatologist. You don't need to understand anything other than thermometers work. Thermometers work. This is my favorite ploy with people who say climate change isn't real. Well, ask all these people suffering flooding over the entire planet. Okay? I tell them, do you believe in thermometers? And of course they say yes. Then I tell them, then you believe in climate change. You just don't understand it because you refuse to look at the data or you don't want to believe it. But if you believe thermometers work, you believe in climate change. It's so sad. Everyone, you know, from China to South America to Eastern United States, look at these tornado outbreaks, right? More energy in the atmosphere. I truly fear that within the next decade, we are going to have a hurricane season that's going to convince people, because of the horrific damage and destruction that they do, I believe that climate change will come to the forefront over the next decade not because of these floods and rains, because everyone is going to pull this, oh, it's a 100-year flood, when it's not, actually, because the last few years has seen incredible flooding all over the planet. But hurricanes are different than tornadoes. And I think what we're going to see is we're going to see a major five. They're going to have to reclassify it to sixes. They're going to have a major five hurricane go right into the fucking bay at New York. There's going to be 9 feet of water, okay, on Wall Street. Then people are going to go, okay, fucking climate change. We need to address it. That's what it's going to take. A sock right in the nose. That's what it's going to take, because people just simply don't want to believe it. It's inconvenient truth, right? We've had that phrase for quite some time now. I've asked all my smart friends, do they know who Dr. Keeling was or what the Keeling curve is? And none of them did. I found it quite shocking.